You want to know what the most common Elder Scrolls Online related questions are that are thrown at me here on this channel? Well, let me tell you. The first is this game pay to win? And the second, what are the benefits of being a subscriber versus a free-to-play player? And well, there is one more question. Can I draw Rule 34 of Nixxiom banging lusty Argonian women? The answer to all of these questions I intend to answer in this video, so that you all will stop asking me them in my comment sections. So let us dive in, shall we? To sub, or not to sub? That is the question. Hashtag not sponsored by ZeniMax, but if ZeniMax does want to send me some cool stuff, that would make me really happy.
Yeah.
When I personally started playing ESO, I was a free-to-play player. I was lost and confused, I was scared and cold, like many of you guys. I ran around in the Nord starting area, I killed some baddies, I made my way to some new lands, and I was having an overall good time. It was cool. So good, in fact, I seriously considered subscribing to the game. I liked it, which led me to the exact same questions that you all have about the game. The first of which was, as you might expect, how pay to win is ESO? Now sure, I was having a good time playing the game so far, but was this just another pay to win MMO? Was it really even worth playing, or was I wasting my time? Well, the answer to that question is, Elder Scrolls Online is not at all pay to win, except for one very small thing, I guess. Now I will say, however, that if you are somebody who really likes cosmetic furniture for your house, then yeah, dude, this game is 100% pay to win, and you will see what I mean by that in one moment. So the game isn't just a big money grab. Great! So what do you get if you become a subscriber anyway? Well, I think the first big thing that you're gonna notice once you subscribe is the fact that now, suddenly, you're gonna have access to all of the game's DLC, excluding whatever the recent expansion might be. Now, at the time of this video's release, the current expansion is Elsweyr, so you wouldn't get that, but everything before it, you got it. A lot of people make the mistake when they get into Elder Scrolls Online of getting the base game and then buying all of the DLC along with it inside of the in-game crown store, on Steam, or whatever. Do not do this! No! By simply becoming a subscriber, you instantly will get all of this. So don't waste your money on each and every expansion and thingy that they've added to the game over the past several years. Suddenly, you're gonna be able to do things like the Dark Brotherhood questline. You can go to places in the world that came out with previous expansions, and you can even check out the new dungeons and features, and it's all in there once you're a sub. Okay? Now, for those of you who think that maybe you won't be able to access any of this stuff because you're not high enough level, you're a new player, whatever, remember, that's not how this game works. The world of ESO scales, so you can go almost anywhere at any time you want, and it's scaled to your current level and experience in the game. So dude, go quest and level up in those expansion zones to your heart's content. Go explore, do a delve, do a dungeon, do whatever you want. The world is yours for the taking. The next big thing that you're gonna notice upon becoming a subscriber is the crafting bag, aka the love sack. Now normally in ESO, as you go throughout the world and gather materials for professions, you're gonna keep them in your backpack. Now managing all those herbs, ores, woods, and trinkets as a free-to-play player, it's a bit of a bitch, let me tell you what. So when you subscribe, you get this thing called a craft bag, where all your profession stuff is just held in this separate, infinitely sized container that you can access at any time for anything. This alone makes subscribing worth it, especially if you're someone who enjoys professions and crafting like I do. This thing is a godsend for us as players, and it usually is stated as the primary reason to subscribe by many people in the player base, including me. The craft bag makes it worth it. at least in my opinion. Next, you're gonna see that your bank space has been doubled in size, and you'll even get access to things like dyeing your armor sets and being able to use additional transmutation crystals. These are items that are used to reroll the stats on your gear if you're not a fan of them, or you didn't get the stats that you were hoping for when it dropped. Now, you get these while you're adventuring, but as a subscriber, you can hang on to double the usual amount of these crystals. So, that's a small perk, and it's pretty cool, you know. Subscribing also gets you access to some progression perks as well, and this is where it kinda becomes a little pay to win, but let me explain. If you're a subscriber, you first and foremost will get a 10% increase to your experience gains to help you level faster. So yeah, if you're a speed leveler, you don't care about the world, the story, the lore, or anything like that, sure, this is gonna be a little bit pay to win for you. You will also get a 10% increase to crafting inspiration and trait research rates. And finally, and this is, in my opinion, for all of us, kind of the big one, you're gonna get a 10% increase to gold drops in the game. Now, I'm a bit torn on this because on one hand, yeah, having more money is great and all in an MMORPG, but on the other, during my time playing ESO, I don't really use gold all that much, aside from when I use it to teleport to places or buy the once in a blue moon item or piece of furniture off of a guild shop. So it's not that game changing or breaking for me, but you guys might have a completely different gameplay style than I do. I don't know, maybe you guys really like working the auction house, buying, trading. I don't know. Play with this feature in game, see how you feel about it, or just leave a comment down below and share your thoughts. That to me, that one thing, is probably the closest thing in this game to being pay to win. Unless, as I mentioned earlier, you're a big fan of furniture. Do you love the Home Improvement channel, boys? Do you love it as much as I do? Well, get ready, bitch, because you're about to get some sweet, sweet lovin'. Why do I say that? Because subscribers get double the amount of furniture space in their player homes. Now, for those of you that don't know, in Elder Scrolls Online, there are a ton of potential player houses that you can have, which you can fill with a lot of stuff. Being a subscriber just means you can shove more crap into that landfill you call a home. So if you're a big fan of interior designing and MMOs, then yeah, being a subscriber in Elder Scrolls Online is 100% a pay-to-win style route for you as a player. But for the other 99% of us that really don't give a shit about how many like trees we have in our front yard or how many chairs we have around our table, you probably aren't really gonna give much of a damn, okay? Just being honest. Lastly, the only other thing to mention when it comes to subscribing is the perks surrounding the Crown Store. So Elder Scrolls Online has this in-game currency called Crowns that you can use to buy cosmetic stuff off of their in-game store, as well as mounts and potions and whatever. Clothing, tattoos, furniture, giant man-eating lion mounts and so on, whatever, you can find it all in there. Well, as a subscriber, you get free crowns every month that you're subscribed, and if and when ZeniMax does a sort of crown store deal or sale, you're gonna get access to it. So pretty much here's how it works. Every month, you're gonna get a free 1,650 crowns, and you can either blow it on something stupid to make your ugly character a little bit less ugly, or you could save it all and buy yourself something really nice down the road, like a chair, or a house, or a mount. I don't know, it's really up to you. And guys, that's it. Those are the perks of becoming a subscriber in Elder Scrolls Online. But the question remains, is subscribing really worth it? And well, in my opinion, kinda. Obviously, if you enjoy the game and find it to be fun, subscribe and support the developers, as they've done so much work in completely revamping and overhauling this game since its horrible launch all those years ago. And they've done a great job too. ESO is in a great state. And obviously, if you're a fan of Elder Scrolls lore and the world in general, yeah, subscribe so that you can experience more of it. If you're a crafter, that crafting bag is going to be a godsend. And if you enjoy decorating player houses, then maybe you're gonna need that extra furniture space. But beyond that, maybe subscribing isn't really worth it for you. If you're just a casual MMO player trying out ESO, giving it a shot for fun, I don't see why you would subscribe. Play it for free and enjoy the massive amount of content the world offers even without all the DLC, and just see what you think. Sure, crafting will be a little more tedious and your bank vault won't be as big, but playing the game for free is not going to ruin the experience for you in the slightest. It didn't for me for the longest time, so I don't think it's going to ruin it for you. But if you do play ESO and you enjoy it, well, at least now you know the perks of if you do subscribe to the game. Guys, I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you do, give it a like. And if you want, subscribe to the channel and be sure to hit that bell for notifications on when I upload. And also, let's take one more moment just to admire this beautiful Nord-inspired shirt. So sexy, right? My friends, these have been such common questions thrown at me here on YouTube, so I hope that your curiosities were sated with this video. And for those of you that have been wondering for a while, like, maybe should I check out ESO? Maybe this video is inspirational for you to go and check out the game. And finally, to wrap things up, no, I do not give you permission to draw Nixxiom banging Argonian women. You might think that's a joke, but that's actually a question I've been asked. So, no, don't do that. Unless you really want to.